Good evening, everyone. My name is Georgios Antsiakidis. I'm a civil engineer, and today I will present you a case of a construction study located in Greece, and more specifically on the island of Kos. Before I begin with my presentation, I would like to make a quick recommendation for our company, ERGOCAD, which is the official distributor of the Tremouri software in Greece and Cyprus. ERGOCAD was founded in 2007, and this day distributes and promotes specialized software solutions in many countries in Europe and also in Australia. In addition to our official website, www.ergocad.eu, we run five other websites related to specific software. In 2015, we started our collaboration with Standard Company in Tremouri, one of the most innovative software for the analysis of structures built in masonry and mixed materials. Since the first moment, we were impressed by the ease of use of pushover analysis and special tools such as verification of local mechanisms. Tremouri quickly became known in Greece and Cyprus, and ERGOCAD was recognized as the best distributor internationally in 2016 and 2017. Today, Tremouri is used in various engineering universities for the preparation of diplomas and dissertations, which you can find on this page. Those who are interested can find an ebook we created for Tremouri, which includes provisions from the Eurocodes and the Greek regulation for building made of masonry, named Kadet in Greek language, which is under development. On our YouTube channel, named ErgoCAD, you can also find the recording of a 5-hour conference that took place at the 16th European Conference on Earthquake Engineering, organized in Thessaloniki, Greece, in June of 2018. The building that I will present you is a two-story building on the island of Kos, built in 1929, which showed damage after the earthquake that occurred in July of 2017. At the bottom left, you see how the mathematical model appears in Tremouri. In this case, we used almost all the available Tremouri tools you see on the slide. Due to a law that applies to earthquake-affected buildings in Greece, we had to use the linear analysis to subsidize the owner for the damage to the building. In the final control, of course, we used pushover analysis, even comparing the individual scenarios of pushover with each other. First and foremost, we verified the geometry of the whole building and every element, and all the laboratory tests were done to find the type of masonry. From various parts of the building, we discovered that it had two layers walls consisting of volcanic rock, marl, limestone and limestone. These photos are from the building. We can see here that there is an existing tie rod on the walls. And finally, we received as the characteristic compressive strength a value FK of 3.05 megapascal. At the same time, we categorize the damages of each wall based on the categories provided by the Greek regulation for earthquake damaged buildings. On the left, we can see the four letters, the four categories A, B, C, D, and on the right, the ground floor plan and the first floor plan. In this slide, you can see again the floor plan of the ground floor and the fixing of the damages. The studies were done by Mrs. Halkidou and Mr. Sifonios. Here we see the categories of each damage. The sum of the damages led us to the conclusion that this is a global failure and not a local one. So it was necessary to proceed with a global analysis. As we mentioned earlier, we had to use the linear analysis because the building was built before 1959 and to insert the seismic forces as horizontal loads to the center of mass of every level with the same value. This is the formula we used, where epsilon is taking the value of 0.14 of g and Ni are the vertical loads of each level. For newer buildings, the distribution is different as it's shown here on the right. So we performed the linear analysis and noted the points where the damages appear on the walls. The goal was to then perform the operations on the damaged elements and to check if they are sufficient or if due to operations failures in other elements occur. Let's see the steps of this procedure. First step, we check the existing building before the damages. We get the results and we continue with the second step. Now we have to repair the damaged elements and check in the same time of the remaining undamaged elements. These are the interventions. First, we remove partially the mortar, install injection tubes at a distance of 30 to 70 centimeters with a diamond shape. Then we have the Limpur IZ8 injection, which contains natural hydraulic lime because we couldn't apply mortar based on cement. Then we add facade grout with Kimia Tectoria M10 mortar. And finally, we have the application of Chemisteel Connect and the wall mesh MR system in two directions. We have to measure that according to the new Greek regulation for the intervention of masonry buildings, which is named CADET. It is under development, as we mentioned earlier. The application of deep pointing from 3 to 5 centimeters increases the compressive strength at about 15 by using this formula, and about 7 when we apply injection grout by using the second formula. In our case, we use both of these interventions plus the wall mesh MR system, and for this reason we increase compressive strength of the wall and the shear strength at about 15%. In this slide we can see the materials. We have the Kimia Tectoria M10 mortar, the lime pour, the wall mesh MR, and the Chemisteel Connect. We also added new brick units and steel bars on the intersection of walls where we had significant damages. Through the next slides, we can see the whole process. The images are not from the real project, but from the brochures of Kimia and Syntec companies. First, we cut out the mortar from the joints. We drilled the wall and we installed the tubes and fasten them on the wall by using beton fix. And we inject lime pour, which is acceptable for historical monuments. Some days later, we started leveling. We prepared the mortar, we laid down the first layer, and then we make it smooth. We put the mesh and we embedded it. Later, we drill the wall and we insert the connectors and we lock them. Finally, we overlay the connectors and apply the final layer of plaster. During the same second step of analysis, we decided to add a new layer with wooden planks in order to improve the displacement of the first floor. After the analysis, we had some failures on undamaged elements, so then we decided to replace the existing timber floor of the second level with a concrete slab, and we added concrete beams on the external walls. Finally, we applied the reinforcement, putting a vertical and horizontal mesh of rebars of 8 millimeters diameter every 15 centimeters. You can see on the right with the blue color the wall mesh MR application, and with the gray color the reinforcement with steel bars. In addition to linear analysis, we ran a static analysis for the verifications of vertical loads as they are described in ERGOCAD 6, where all the walls had enough bearing capacity. We can see the results here. We also ran a model analysis in order to determine the node which has the maximum displacement. This could be the chondron node of the Pushover analysis. And because we wanted to find the percentage of the mass which is effective for each mode, and later we checked the walls through a seismic analysis for the out-of-plane bending. As we can see, all the colors were green. That means that all the checks are satisfied. As we explained earlier, for the linear analysis, we took a ground acceleration of 0.14 of g because of the Greek regulation. The real ground acceleration because of this earthquake was estimated at about 0.6 to 0.20 of g. We collected this data from the website www.itsac.gr, and for this reason we decided to run additionally some scenarios by using Pushover analysis. For the Pushover analysis, we took a peak ground acceleration of 0.24 of g, which is the value according to the current seismic zones of Greece. We ran analysis first for the existing building, and as we can see on the diagrams, the A factor, which is the ratio of PGA of each limit state for each Pushover analysis, to 0.24g is over the one except the damage limitation state for the x direction, which is 0.9. On the opposite, all the factors for the Pushover on y direction are under the one value, as we can see in this diagram. Here we present the results after the applied interventions. We see that all the A factors are over the one except the damage limitation factor on y direction here, which remains on a low level. But since the decision of the owner was to check the building for the severe damage state, we didn't go further in analysis. Also, we have to note that the maximum displacement of the existing building was 1.63 in x direction and 98 in y direction. After the intervention, we had 2.65 and almost 3 in y direction. Based on the results of another Pushover analysis where we used ground acceleration of 0.14 of g, similar to the linear analysis, we can say that the total cost of intervention could be reduced at about 30% comparing to the conservative results of the linear analysis for the same ground acceleration. It is worthwhile to mention that Remuri gives a lot of tools to the end user. In this case, for example, we run pushover analysis for all the main direction and eccentricities of the 3D model, 24 in total, but we also run additional analysis for more direction in order to verify how the structure reacts to the direction of the real seismic force. Some other useful tools of Tremuri are presented here. We can compare the pushover curves, the different scenarios of intervention in order to find the most efficient in terms of cost. We can see the stresses under each wall, or we can run pushover analysis for every single wall, assuming that it is isolated from the other elements. We also, in this example, checked how the structure can be responded if we divide it in two parts. The results were obviously better, but the division is not acceptable because of the region where the structure is built. One of the advantages of Tremuri is the tool of local mechanism, which helps us to check every single part of the walls for the out-of-plane behavior. You can see here an example. On the left, there is a failure. For this reason, we inserted some tie rods, or we replaced the existing ones on this structure. You can watch a detailed webinar for local mechanism in Greek language in our YouTube channel. In conclusion, we need to mention that there are some parts of Eurocode 8.3 which lead the engineers to use pushover analysis. These parts are on the opposite direction of the Greek regulation for the damaged masonry buildings, but we hope in the future there will be a common solution for these types of structures. More specifically, in Eurocode 8.3, the application of linear methods has to follow these conditions. The floors possess enough in plane stiffness and sufficiently connected to the perimeter walls. Floors on opposite sides of a common wall have to be at the same height. Walls are continuous along their height, and lateral load-resisting walls are regularly arranged in both of horizontal directions. If you check these images, for example, you can see that the buildings on the right are not valid for the application of linear method. The same in this slide. Non-linear methods should be applied when the conditions are not met. Since all the existing masonry buildings have floors made of timber, it's not possible for the engineers to use linear analysis, and it is something that has to be solved in the future. In this last slide, we can see some of the most important companies in Greece and Cyprus that have already invested in Tremuri. Thanks for your attention.